that abysmal loss. Put the Cowboys on firmer ground to make, the playoffs, you know, and have an opportunity to get in the second season, you know, and we'll see what happens from there. Look, Dallas Cowboys, richest franchise, most profitable, or franchise, what's the term? I don't know if you're there. They're the most profitable sports franchise in the world. And so, winning on the field and Super Bowls hasn't, and their lack thereof in that category, has not affected their bottom line. Okay? Jerry continues to make money hand over fist. And by all accounts, he's going to continue to that trend will go on into the future. His son, Steven, is set up to take over going forward. And the financial success of the organization, as far as I'm concerned, will remain intact. Very similar to the Yankees. You know, when George stepped away, rest in peace, Mr. Steinbrenner. Again, born in the great state of New Jersey, grew up in Rockland County, New York. Went to a number of Yankees games, also the Mets, which is my team. Just to put that out there in terms of, you know, but the tradition, the history, the legacies of the Yankees organization are like no other. You know, and those things, that mythology, allows these owners to be tremendously profitable, good, bad, and different. Yankees organization has been, frankly, much more consistent than the Cowboys. Where am I going with this? The Dallas Cowboys would be the New England Patriots if Jerry Jones had not fired Jimmy Johnson. Period. Get excited about that. But, you know, you have to if you're a sports person. That's one of the things for me. It's a sticking point. Okay? I don't understand. I didn't understand it then, and now it's only exacerbated for me. Right? All of this glamour and this wonder and this hype surrounding the Cowboys. Jerry Starbuck, most people, and I'm a history person, and I have to kind of dig deep to remember who Jerry Starbuck was. They don't remember the great Cowboys teams of the 70s, right? The Cowboys image, you know, and what people get hype about now, today, over 25 years, or about 25 years after their last Super Bowl, has to do with what Jimmy Johnson built in the 90s. Saw a pretty cool graphic. We'll get that for you on the screen. After Bill Belichick was fired as head coach of the Cleveland Browns, he sought out, hunted down Jerry Jones. Excuse me, at some sort of social event. Not particularly, you know, but he made a point to know where Jerry Jones was going to be, and then he personally went up to Jerry Jones and said, "Look, you know that, you know, I've been let go, got fired. You know, we all know this. I'm a good football coach. Don't forget about me." Moral of that story is, you know, now all these years later, that's something that Jerry Jones, I think, and I know, thinks quite hard about late into the evening, deep into the night, in terms of what could have been. Well, listen, as far as I'm concerned, that being a cool story in and of itself is secondary to the fact that the Dallas Cowboys could and should have been the New England Patriots if Jerry Jones would have let Jimmy spin. All of this hype and this chest pounding, you know? I'm not a huge Patriots fan. Like I said, I'm from the state of New Jersey, so I didn't grow up with it. But for all you Patriots fans out there, I keep doing what you're doing. Because you ain't faking the funk. And the rings and the success and the future success speaks to it. Bob Ryan, in his outstanding book, Scribe, alludes to the fact that there was zero football tradition in New England pre-Bill Belichick. Folks don't even know where the Patriots played before they moved to Foxborough. And again, me, you know, this is something that I'm going to have to get the graphic up for you. I had to dig into the archives. Much different. Not in any way, shape, or form similar to the Boston Red Sox. Fenway Park. 1912. And that culture, tradition, and legacy of, now we all know this, you know, the World Series drought, but greatness over many decades and generations. There's this idea, because we're in the midst of greatness and success, that it's always been like this in Foxborough for the Patriots. And again, back to Bob Ryan. No. It begins with Bill Belichick. And is quite young in the scope of the NFL's history. 20 years running of outstanding success, which has lifted a region, a fan base. Why is Boston the number one sports city in the United States, year in and year out? Patriots have a lot to do with it, okay? And where is this rant and rave, one of many, going? That could have been 20-plus years of excellence in a huge, major market, the Dallas Cowboys. If Jerry Jones had allowed his football people to run the show.